Everyone's been telling me to use Portainer instead of Docker Desktop. And I've got to say, I had no idea it was this good. Don't believe me? Well, in this video, I'm going to compare Portainer to three other Docker web UIs. Let's go. We'll start, of course, with Portainer, which is essentially a web-based UI for managing your containers. You can get started with the Community Edition for free, and if you already have Docker Desktop, then you just need to run these two commands. Bear in mind, if you're running it locally, then make sure you change these ports to port 9000. And that's it. You're now ready to start managing containers like a pro. The dashboard gives you an overview of your stacks, containers, images, volumes, and networks. Yes, I know, 56 images is a lot. But anyway, clicking on containers will give you container states. I can scroll down and click here to view all the logs. If I go back, I can click on this button over here to get container stats like memory, CPU, and network. I can go back and click here to run commands inside my container. I can also view container IP addresses and published ports. Clicking on images, I can view all the images I have. And if I want to add one, I can click here, search for it, find the correct tag. So I can find this tag over here, add it here and pull the image. I can view my networks here, volumes and events. But what's really cool is the templates, which provide you with pre-configured apps that you can use straight away. And there are a lot of them. I could also click here and create a custom template from an existing one and edit the Docker Compose file to my liking. Speaking of Docker Compose, I can click on stacks over here and add a new stack to start creating a Docker Compose file from scratch right inside my browser. And the beauty of Portainer is that because this is a web UI, I could deploy this on an EC2 instance somewhere to manage all my containers. Now, I could go on and talk about more Portainer features, but I think it's time to move on to another app. Let's talk about Dockage. Just like Portainer, Dockage or Dockage can be installed with Docker. Just make sure that if you're on Docker Desktop to add these extra directories or it won't work. But apart from that, it's really simple to install. Let's take a look at it. If you're familiar with Uptime Kuma, then you'll be familiar with the Dockage UI. Speaking of Uptime Kuma, if you want to learn more about it, check out this video that we've made. Now, immediately, you can see that Dockage doesn't have as much information as Portainer. This is because Dockage is a tool for managing Docker Compose stacks. So I can click on Compose, and immediately I'll get an Nginx Compose config. I can, of course, edit the ports here. I can add another container if I wanted to, and edit that to change the ports. But for now, I'll just stick with Nginx. So I'll click delete. And if I wanted to add networks, I could do so here. I could even edit this file by typing into it, but we'll leave all the defaults for now. And once I'm done, I can hit deploy to deploy this app. Cool, that was quick. So I can see its logs over here. I can access the terminal over here and I can restart, stop and delete the container. I'll stop it for now. I'll admit the features here for creating a compose file or stack is much better than what's on Portainer. But I wish I could do more than just manage stacks that were created in Dockage. Okay, so that's Dockage or Dockage. Now, let's move on to Dozzle. Dozzle is an open source log viewer for Docker containers. In fact, we've already made a video about Dozzle explaining what it is. Check out the description if you want the link to it. But it's really easy to install and has a very fast and nice UI. Let's take a look at it. So this is Dozzle, and it's currently showing containers that are running in this dashboard. I can click on one of them to view all the container logs. So I can go back to click on another one, which has more logs, and I can scroll up to see the percentage that I've scrolled through in the logs. I can see memory and load over here. And if I wanted to, I could download all the logs. I could toggle between log levels, and I can do a find by pressing Command F and search with regex. But one of my favorite features of Dozzle is this merge logs ability, where I can see logs from all the containers in one view. I can even go as far as seeing all the logs inside my host by clicking on here and scroll through all the logs on Docker Desktop. That is really nice. So if all you want to do is view and search through logs, then Dozzle is a great tool for that. But if you want to do a bit more, then I'd reach for a tool like Portainer. Speaking of logs, if you want an easy way to manage all your container logs without self-hosting a Docker web UI, then you should check out BetterStack. BetterStack can receive logs from Docker through a tool like Vector. And from there, you can benefit from super fast log search and log filtering, as well as lots of other features like alerts, dashboards, metrics, status pages, and much more. And you can use these features now with a really generous free tier. So what's your excuse? Go ahead and check out BetterStack today. And we're back. Okay, we've got one last tool to talk about, which is Yacht. Like all the others, it's really easy to install, but I feel like I might have installed it incorrectly. Maybe it's a skill issue. Check this out. So the dashboard works fine. I mean, the UI could be improved, but the dashboard works. So if I click the container, look at processes, nothing, look at logs, nothing, look at stats, nothing. And then if I go back to the dashboard, the container's gone, like it was never there in the first place. And if I go to the UI, click on resources, go to images, nothing, volumes, the same, and even networks. Now, I know Yacht is being rewritten in TypeScript, so all of these issues may be resolved in the future. But for now, I'd stay clear of Yacht. So basically, if you want a nice web-based UI for managing containers, then just stick with Portainer. Unless you can think of a better web-based tool, then let me know in the comments.